That's it. I'm done with this piece of sh**. This thing is sucking bad now. Goodbye, Windows 11. I won't miss ya.
Boo! You suck!
It's just too problematic, especially if you are an AMD user. Frame drop, slowdown, too much RAM consumption, etc, etc. And allegedly some other issues I've got rid of once I downgraded to Windows 10. Okay, so let's reveal the issues one by one and justify my downgrade just before the end of life. The first issue was logging in with the Microsoft account, which was luckily bypassed by the PC builders of the shop from where I bought the PC right before the bypass was blocked by Microsoft. The second most annoying issue was stuttering. Stuttering even on older games. My doubt had started when a game named Xenotic was first stuttering on a 7800 XT. That game run on average 80 FPS in my freaking old GT630 and don't stutter that much on Windows 8.1. But the same level of stuttering was happening on a 7800 XT. But after downgrading, the stutter was gone, like completely. I don't know how and why it happened, but clearly Windows 11 has an optimization issue in terms of gaming performance. Another issue was simply almost no new features. The Android subsystem was discontinued, and I think it was the only feature that most people cared about when Windows 11 was first announced. And other features like better asymmetric core architecture handling. I mean, in short, I'm talking about better P and E core handling. But I'm using a Ryzen 7 7700, so it isn't necessary for me. And auto HDR? Good luck getting an HDR supported monitor. And to be fair, I got one, but you need a proper implementation of HDR, which my budget 1440p gaming monitor doesn't have. There are some other minor improvements, but seriously, it isn't worth it over the issues I've faced in Windows 11, which I'll talk about now. And now some other alleged issues that I've got rid of after downgrading to Windows 10. First and the most annoying issue was connecting to my wireless soundbar via Bluetooth, and man, that was a pain in Windows 11. Windows 11 was pretending like the soundbar didn't even exist. So I had to remove the device and reconnect it every time when I had to switch from my headphone to my soundbar for relaxing in Forza Horizon 3 or watching YouTube. But in Windows 10, it instantly recognized the bar and I have to face it for once, like yeah, for once. And every time else, it just connects fine and instantly. Another fact is the CPU temps feel slightly lower. I mean, when my Windows 11 machine was idle, it was still clocking up to its maximum turbo for no reason, like 4.9 to 5.3 GHz in idle, which resulted in increased temps while it was idle. Even taking it to balanced mode didn't work. I was kind of lost in this issue, but in Windows 10, temps and clocks are fixed. Now my CPU usually clocks at 4.3 GHz at idle, which results an average 5 degrees Celsius decrease over Windows 11. Like, it's even funnier thing that a Windows version change can cool down your CPU. Now I know what you're thinking, and no spooky things other than Spidos themselves were running in the background. I've checked it multiple times, and the idle CPU usage was normal even in Windows 11. It's just the clock speed that was unusual. And not to mention the bloatwares and ads. These are really problematic for low-end PCs. To be fair, it's also present in Windows 10 and I always update only the Defender and block all the features and bloater updates. Fortunately, Windows 10 doesn't receive any feature and bloater crap nowadays because I think Microsoft has discontinued it a few years ago, I guess. I also noticed a thing that many people don't talk about much. Remember Windows 10 from 2015 to 2021? People said that it was an okay operating system, but many individuals and tech enthusiasts hated that OS, including me. One of the main reasons was those feature updates, And man, I still remember whenever Microsoft pushed a new feature update, many users always complained about hundreds of bugs, things not working, getting BSOD, etc., etc. And not to mention their PCs were running worse than before. And now, same thing is happening to Windows 11. And notice how Windows 10 is working fine now without those crappy feature updates. One YouTube commenter said that when Windows 12 will release, Windows 10 will be remembered as a legendary operating system. I don't exactly remember the comment, but that user said something like that. Looking at Microsoft's current cash-grabbing mentality, it makes sense to say that, and it may be true, who knows? So, what you should do about it, and what I should do too. Firstly, I'm thinking to make another video about it, but I should hint you some basics. First, don't try to get a new PC if you can't afford it. Try to switch to an easy-to-use Linux distro like Pop! OS, Linux Mint, etc., or even Bazite if you're into gaming. And I'm also thinking to switch to Linux if zero patches, security patches ain't enough for Windows 10. But in the end, Microsoft deserves a downfall. It feels like the company is focusing on their stock market rather than customer service. That's all I had to say. So, like and subscribe if you like this video, or just at least give a thumbs up. Till then, peace.